Hi guys, in the previous session we started with the third theme, that is kingship, caste and class, and in that we saw an important long answer. Before seeing the long answer, we saw the critical edition done by a group of scholars under the leadership of B.S. Sutankar. We saw that, and they produced 13,000 pages and took almost 47 years to produce the edition of this critical edition of Mahabharata. And they came out with two important points. One is, they said, all the text in Sanskrit are very, very common, and according to the regional variations, there were some modifications also done in Mahabharata. That is what they came up with. Then we went on to study an important first long answer in this chapter, that is the rules and varied practices with respect to kingship and marriage. And in that we saw a lot of points under the each heading had two or three points. First heading we saw about the families, and in that family is just not a members living in a house, but also a larger network of relatives from father's and mother's side, and all that we saw. And we went on to see the idea of patrilineage. Patrilineage was adopted not during this Mahabharata being composed, but it was existing even before. But what Mahabharata did, it reinforced this idea into the people's mind. And that is the reason it is existing even today. If there are no natural sons, then there should be no brothers to take up and all that. Like some exceptions are there, like Prabhavati Gupta and all that we saw. Then we also saw some of the sources. Please read the sources again and again. Then we went on to see different types of marriages. Then rules of marriages. We saw what is existing in today's time, especially in North India. That is exogamy to be practiced and kanyadan to be given to the daughter, and this is the religious duty of every father that we saw. Then we went on to see what are some of the complexities faced by the brahmanas because of this towns and cities coming up. For that reason, they came up with new codes of social behavior with 8 forms of marriages. In that, the first 4 are considered to be good and the last 4 are considered to be condemned. And we saw that. Then we went on to see the next topic, Gotra of women. And here there are 2 rules for Gotra. That is, the after the marriage, the women are supposed to take up the Gotra of the husband. And the first one take up, where is that, the 2 rules, expected to take father's, give up father's gotra and expected to adopt the husband's, then the members of the same gotra cannot marry. And we have an very important exceptions in the form of satvahanas who broke both these rules laid down by the brahmanas. So that is also very important. We saw that. Then yes, Satvahana is the only group which had metronymics, that is named after the mother. And whether these mothers are important, no, they are not. To the succession theory, they are not important because they even practice patrilineage even in Satvahana rule. Okay. So this was our last topic of the first question of this lesson. And whatever I summarized now, if you write that much in 8 points, that's more than sufficient for this. Now we are getting into the another very important topic, that is social differences within and beyond the framework of caste. There are some social differences existing within caste. Caste system emerged from these 4 varnas. We are going to see these 4 varnas, and beyond this caste there are some social differences also. We are going to see that. Any question can come, okay? Any question related to caste, if it comes in your exam, and the answer should be from here, okay? Related to caste, the wordings may be different, they can phrase any type of sentences to make you understand. But the answer is here. Okay, as we go ahead, you will come to know more and more points and you will be comfortable in answering this. See, we are very, very familiar with this term called caste. Okay, means set of hierarchically ordered social categories. What is this caste? Caste meaning a set of hierarchically ordered social categories. There is an order, but not accepted by all. Okay. So the ideal order was laid down in Dharma Sutras and Dharma Shastras. So ideal, मतलब ये proper order कहाँ पे हमको मिलते हैं? ये दोनों book, very important book, book these two books, you know, Dharma Sutras and Dharma Shastras. Brahmanas claimed that this order in which they were ranked first, and they are called, they are divinely ordained. Ordained means abhishek kiya gaya, ya they are being chosen by God. So they are ranked first, Brahmanas, while placing groups classified as Shudras and untouchables at the bottom of the social order. So at the top we have Brahmanas, at the bottom we have Shudras, and it is said that they are supposedly determined by birth. All these positions are supposedly determined by birth. So this is just introduction to this. You need not write this. Just to understand, okay, but what is caste, you should know. And the first heading that you need to put here is the right occupation. Now every person being part of this varna system has to perform a particular task or particular occupation. Based on the occupation, the person's caste is decided or determined by the Dharma Sutras and Dharma Shastras. So they have lot of rules and regulations for this. There are four varnas or four categories. Brahmanas were supposed to study and teach the Vedas. We all know this. Please, ये बहुत easy है, लेकिन हम कभी-कभी confused हो जाते हैं, अच्छे से लिख नहीं पाते, so we may not able to score the full mark. So you need to know this, okay? Brahmanas were supposed to study and teach the Vedas and perform sacrifices and get sacrifices performed and give and receive gifts. This is the duty of the Brahmanas. The second, Kshatriya's duty. It is their duty is to engage in warfare, battle, protect the people and administer justice. Ye, iske saath saath study the Vedas, get sacrifices performed and make gifts. Ye bhi, receive gifts by Brahmanas, make gifts by the last three, that is study the Vedas, get sacrifices performed and make gifts. Ye, even Vaishyas, the third category, also does. In addition to one more thing, that is agriculture. So agriculture. So Vaishya's duty kya kya hai? To study Vedas, to get sacrifices performed and make gifts, as well as do engage themselves in agriculture and pastoralism and trade. Yes, agriculture, pastoralism and trade. The last one, that is Shudras, who are assigned only one occupation, that is the serving the three higher varnas. Unka ek hi duty hai. Ye upar ke jo teen categories hai, उन तीनों को सर्व करना, सर्विस देना. सो दैट इज द सो वेरी वेरी सिंपल क्वेश्चन, बट यू मस्ट हैव बीन स्टडीइंग दिस इन योर लोअर क्लासेस एंड ऑल दैट. ओके, नाउ व्हाट इज मोर इम्पोर्टेंट इज दिस इन योर आंसर. यू नीड टू राइट दैट ऑल्सो, एंड यू नीड टू राइट दिस. ब्राह्मणास इवॉल्व्ड टू और थ्री स्ट्रैटेजीज टू एनफोर्स दिस नॉर्म्स. नॉर्म्स तो बना दिया, ये जो ड्यूटीज है, ड्यूटीज को नॉर्म्स भी कहते हैं. रूल्स क्या क्या रूल्स है, मतलब ब्राह्मणास का क्या ड्यूटी है, क्षत्रियास का क्या, वैश्यास का, इनको एनफोर्स करने के लिए इन्होंने टू और थ्री स्ट्रैटेजीज बनाए. व्हाट इज दैट स्ट्रैटेजी? द फर्स्ट स्ट्रैटेजी, दैट इज द फर्स्ट स्ट्रैटेजी इज वाज टू असर्ट दैट वर्णा ऑर्डर वाज ऑफ डिवाइन ओरिजिन. ये लोगों को सबको समझा देते हैं कि इसको आपको फॉलो करना ही है, क्योंकि ये एक डिवाइन ओरिजिन है. इट इज गिवन बाय गॉड, सो यू हैव टू परफॉर्म. द फर्स्ट स्ट्रैटेजी बहुत अच्छा स्ट्रैटेजी है, जब भगवान का नाम ले लेते हैं हम सब सुन लेते हैं. सो फर्स्ट स्ट्रैटेजी. सेकंड स्ट्रैटेजी, दे एडवाइज द किंग्स टू इंश्योर दैट दीज नॉर्म्स आर फॉलोड विद इन देयर किंगडम. पहले तो बोल दिया, भगवान ने दिया तो आधे से ज्यादा लोग मान लेंगे. अगर कोई कोई नहीं मानता है तो उनके लिए एक और है, दैट इज किंग्स. किंग्स को बताया कि अगर कोई फॉलो नहीं कर रहा, यू हैव टू टेक एक्शन अगेंस्ट देम. सो दिस इज द सेकंड स्ट्रैटेजी. द थर्ड स्ट्रैटेजी वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट, दैट दे अटेम्प्ट टू पर्सुएड द पीपल that their status was determined by birth. हमने कुछ नहीं किया, भगवान ने दिया, आपको फॉलो करना ही है, और ये हमने आपको ये नहीं बताया कि आप शूद्र हैं वैश्य हैं, आपके कलर देख के, आपका ड्रेस देख के, आपका इकोनॉमिक स्टेटस देख के हमने नहीं बताया। इट इज जस्ट बाय योर बर्थ। इफ यू आर टेकिंग बर्थ इन अ शूद्रास फैमिली यू आर शूद्र, इफ यू आर टेकिंग बर्थ इन ब्राह्मणा ब्राह्मणा। सो दीज आर द थ्री स्ट्रैटेजी। दिस क्वेश्चन इज वेरी ऑफन आस्क्ड इन मोस्ट ऑफ द एग्जाम। सो दीज आर द थ्री स्ट्रैटेजीज इवॉल्व बाई द ब्राह्मणास टू एनफोर्स दिस फोर वर्णास। सो वेरी वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट एंड आई थिंक आई मेड इट वेरी क्लियर टू यू। हाउएवर दिस वॉज नॉट वेरी इजी बिकॉज नो ऑल दैट इज फाइन। ओके या दिस सोर्स सिक्स इज वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट, डिवाइन ऑर्डर टू जस्टिफाई देयर क्लेम्स। दैट क्लेम्स क्या है ये फोर थ्री स्ट्रैटेजीज to justify their claims, brahmanas often cited a verse from the hymn in rigveda known as purusha suktika. very very important. so to tell them that you know rigveda mein ek verse hai, hymn hai, song hai, usko bar bar ye dohrate hain during sacrifices and all that, to tell that you know why we should follow. all the elements in the universe including four social categories were supposed to have emanated from the body of this purusha. that is purusha is nobody but the primal first man, that is god. so everything including this four varnas, everything came from god. emanated means came from god. everything came from god including this four supposed to come from his body only, is from him only. so they are giving brahmana was his mouth, brahmana is his mouth, his arms, his arms were kshatriyas, his thighs were vaishyas, and his feet is shudra. that is why shudras are at the bottom, brahmanas are the top. okay, because brahmanas are considered to be the mouth of lord brahma or you know purusha, or you know the arms of purusha were kshatriyas, the thighs were vaishyas, and the shudras are feet. this is a very important source for exam as well as for your life. very very important. now proper social roles, another very important source is this, and this is nothing but a story of a person called Eklavya. you must have studied and known this, heard this story so many times in your life. There was a guru brahmana called Drona. he was the actually he was the teacher for Arjuna. so he was teaching Arjuna the archery, and he told Arjuna that nobody on this earth could be better than you in archery. so but when a group of princes from Kuru dynasty, when they went to the forest and they saw Ekalavya practicing, actually Ekalavya approached Drona to teach him, but he denied because he was a forest dweller. forest dwellers are called as nishadas. okay, so he was denied. Drona denied him teaching. so he made the small image of Drona out of clay. मिट्टी से एक Drona का स्टैचू इमेज बनाया, उसको सामने रख के उसके टीचर ग्रुप में मान के ही हिमसेल्फ प्रैक्टिस्ड बाई हिज ओन. ही प्रैक्टिस एंड ही बिकेम सो मच नो वेल वर्स्ड इन आर्चरी. when a dog of this Kuru princess saw Eklavya being very black man and looking very strange, started barking at him. when it was barking at him, what he did was Ekalavya shot seven arrows into the mouth of this dog, and when the dog returned to Pandavas, they were amazed at this superb display of archery, and they tracked down this Ekalavya, and Ekalavya introduced himself as a student of Drona. I came to you and you denied, and I myself learned. And when Arjuna asked him, you said nobody can be better, or I would be the person the best in archer in this earth, but he is trying to claim more than me. Then Drona made an idea. asked him, if you are my student, what gift are you going to give to the guru? You ask anything that you wish. Then he said, I want your right thumb as my fee. And Eklavya unhesitatingly, without hesitation, just cut it off and offered to him. And then he was not able to shoot any archery, and thus Drona was able to win over Eklavya and make Arjuna as the best in the world. No one was better than Arjuna. He proved, he kept his word. So if you have recently watched a movie called Super 30, this was the theme of that movie. This was the turning point in the movie for the hero, know, to give up training the high class society people, students, and making them IIT students, and and he went on to choose a super, the 30 students from the lower lower caste people, and started teaching them freely, and he proved to be. And when he was traveling on that, when he travels on the rickshaw one night, and the rickshaw puller tells this story, Ekalavya and Dronacharya and all that story, and that made him open his mind and wisdom. Then he takes a decision in his life and changes. How far it is true, we are not sure, but yes. And Raja ka beta, Raja hi banega, and that is being all our scriptures and all our Hindu Sanskritic traditions tells us this. Anyway, good. That is the second point that we talked about. The first, let us go back. Yeah, the right occupation. We talked about the right occupation. We have enough and more to write in this. And two sources also, very important sources. Please go through. Now we are moving to the next one, next heading, that is the non-Kshatriya kings. According to the Shastras, or that is Dharma Shastras, only Kshatriyas can become kings. But we have a lot of kings here. Just an example you have to write. Lot of kings who became rulers, so many people who became rulers who were not of Kshatriya origin. Kshatriya origin nahi hai. So one best example is Mauryas. The Mauryas, unka jo background, social background hai, even today it is hotly debated. People are not very sure whether they are from Kshatriya origin or not. Some Buddhist texts suggest that they were Kshatriyas. Some Brahmanical texts suggest that they are being very low origin, socially very low. I am reading from the book only, okay? ऐसा लगता होगा कि सर कुछ मतलब अपने मन से बोल रहे हैं नहीं आई एम जस्ट नो लुकिंग इनटू द बुक एंड नो मेकिंग यू अंडरस्टैंड प्लीज वॉच द वीडियो अगेन एंड अगेन इफ यू डोंट अंडरस्टैंड एंड कीप योर बुक इन फ्रंट एक्चुअली वी हैव अटैच द पीडीएफ फाइल ऑफ द बुक इन योर स्टडी बेस ऐप कैन नो गो टू द ऐप एंड डाउनलोड बुक अदरवाइज यू हैव एनसीईआरटी वेबसाइट में आपको ई बुक्स में भी मिल जाएंगे. So if you do not have the book, please download the PDF from the NCERT or from our school study base app, and get the book, make some printouts and all that, okay, study. So first one is Mauryas, who are supposed to be, according to Buddhist texts, supposed to be Kshatriyas. According to Brahmanical texts, they are supposed to be low origin. So first example, non-Kshatriya kings. Short answer alag se aa sakte hain. मेक ए शॉर्ट नोट ऑन नॉन क्षत्रिय किंग्स करके एक टॉपिक क्वेश्चन अलग से भी आ सकता है सो प्लीज मेक नो मेक शॉर्ट नोट्स फॉर दिस द सेकेंड एग्जाम्पल इज शुंगास एंड कन्वास एंड दीज टू आर द इमीडिएट सक्सेसेस ऑफ मौर्यस तो मौर्यस के बाद जो दो और रूलिंग डायनेस्टी आया था शुंगा डायनेस्टी एंड कन्वा डायनेस्टी और ये दोनों क्षत्रियस नहीं ब्राह्मणस है ये सब हिस्ट्री में बताया जा रहा है इसलिए दे आर नॉट क्षत्रियास दे आर ब्राह्मणास इनफैक्ट पॉलिटिकल पावर इफेक्टिवली ओपन टू एनीवन उस समय पॉलिटिकल पावर ओपन था कि दोज हु हैड पावर सपोर्ट मस्टर सपोर्ट ऑफ द पीपल एंड हैव मोर रिसोर्सेस एंड नीड नॉट बी यू नो बाय बर्थ एज अ क्षत्रिया कैन बिकम रूलर्स अदर रूलर्स लाइक शाकास वी स्टडीड दिस इन द लास्ट चैप्टर ऑल्सो शाकास हु केम फ्रॉम सेंट्रल एशिया दे वर कंसिडर्ड टू बी मेलचास मेलचास आर नोबडी बट बारबेरियंस आर आउटसाइडर्स Brahmanas कहते हैं दे आर मेलिचास एंड दे आर बारबेरियंस दे आर आउटसाइडर्स फ्रॉम नॉट फ्रॉम इंडिया हाउएवर दिस इज थर्ड थर्ड वन ओके नाउ हाउएवर वन ऑफ द अर्लीस्ट इंस्क्रिप्शन ऑफ संस्कृत डिस्क्राइब्स दैट रुद्रदमन एट द बेस्ट नोन शाका रूलर रुद्रदमन के बारे में हमने लास्ट चैप्टर में एक सोर्स में पढ़ा था इफ यू नो इफ यू आर नॉट प्लीज गो गो एंड स्टडी ही रीबिल्ड द सुदर्शन लेक नो रीबिल्ड मीन्स इट वॉज ऑलरेडी बिल्ट एंड ही रेनोवेटेड ही No, he repaired the lake because it was fully damaged, and he repaired this. And this suggests that powerful Melchas, this Rudradaman is a Shaka ruler. Okay, question aa sakte hain one marker mein. So he powerful Melchas were familiar with Sanskrit traditions. He doing good for the people, for the society by renovating this Sudarshana lake. So he was doing some good work for the people. It is also interesting that the best known ruler called Satavahana dynasty ka jo Gautama Buddha Sri Satakarani, please underline this. He claimed himself as a unique Brahmana. That is, he said that I am two. I am both. One is unique Brahmana, that is Ekka Brahmana, and the destroyer of the pride of Kshatriyas. Ye jo pride hai na ki only Kshatriyas, only Rajput, we only can rule. ये जो प्राइड है उसको मैं डिस्ट्रॉय करने वाला हूँ. एनीबडी कैन रूल एंड आई एम अ ब्राह्मण, आई एम द ओनली वन ब्राह्मण, आई एम वेरी यूनिक ब्राह्मण, एक ब्राह्मण एंड आई विल डिस्ट्रॉय. सो ही क्लेम्स हिमसेल्फ, ही क्लेम्स टू बी बोथ यूनिक ब्राह्मण एंड डिस्ट्रॉय द डिस्ट्रॉयर ऑफ द प्राइड ऑफ क्षत्रियस. सो दिस टू अ वेरी वन मार्कर के लिए और फिर से एक बहुत इंपॉर्टेंट है. He also claimed to have ensured that there was no intermarriage among the members of the four Varnas. Four Varnas के बीच में intermarriage नहीं होना चाहिए. ब्राह्मणास ब्राह्मणास की कम्युनिटी में करेंगे और क्षत्रियास की कम्युनिटी में ही शादी करेंगे. सो ही सेड नो इंटर मैरिज बिटवीन दिस. एट द सेम टाइम दिस वल्लभ एंड देन मैरिड विद रुद्र दमन किन, उनके रिलेटिव्स में, रुद्र दमन के रिलेटिव्स में इसने एक. सो सत्वर्णास ऑलवेज लाइक दिस, दे आर नो दे आर जस्ट अगेंस्ट द सोशल ऑर्डर. सो बट ही सेड लाइक दैट, एट द सेम टाइम ही वेंट इन मैरिज अलायंस विद द शाका रूलर्स. ओके so that is fine for this. Yeah, yes, another very important. So they, you know, they claim to uphold the fourfold varna, but you know, they themselves, like, you know, practiced all the excluded, everything that was excluded from the society was about practice kar rahe. Jaise endogamy supposed to be exogamy, but you know, they were practicing endogamy. They were supposed to practice patrilineage, taking the name of the father, but no, they were taking the mother of the name of the mother, as well as they never changed the surname even after the marriage, the women of Satvanas and all that. So there, so the second one, non Kshatriya kings, you have enough and more examples in the form of Mauryas, then Shungas, Kanvas, then you have Shaka rulers, then you have Satvanas also. Then the another third heading is Jatis. We have Jati is nothing, no much difference between Jati and caste, or that Varna, four Varnas join was, but there are so many things that was happening beyond this four varna. ये four varna से बाहर भी बहुत कुछ हो रहा था. तो लोग, no, the brahmanical people, brahmanas were so much confused what to do with this. So what they said is, in brahmanical theory, jati like varna was based on birth only. However, while number of varnas was fixed just to four, there was no restriction on the number of jatis. Jatis का कोई number नहीं है. Anybody, like, no, a person belonging to doing the work of goldsmith, then that is a swarnakara, then you have sutta, then you have kumar and all that. So that surname emerged from this jati only. So so new groups aane lage, so according to the groups they started inventing a new term called jati. So jatis which shared a common occupation or profession are sometimes organized into shreni. Please, very very important, ye shrenis kya hai? जातिस जो एक जैसा कॉमन प्रोफेशन ऑक्यूपेशन करते हैं, श्रेणी लाइक क्राफ्ट, क्राफ्ट प्रोडक्शन, लाइक नो गोल्ड स्मिथ, ब्लैक स्मिथ, ये सब एक एक सुतार, एक कम्युनिटी जाति, एक नो राजपूत, अनदर जाति, अनदर कम्युनिटी, लाइक दैट. वी सेल्डम कम अक्रॉस द डॉक्यूमेंट दैट रिकॉर्ड द हिस्ट्रीज ऑफ दिस ग्रुप्स. वी हैव वन इंटरेस्टिंग इंस्क्रिप्शन इन अ प्लेस कॉल्ड मंसूर इन मध्य प्रदेश. And this talks about, this records a history of a guild, a group of people, guild of silk weavers who were originally from Gujarat, the place called Lata, and they came from Lata, Gujarat, and they came, migrated to Mansur. And Mansur at that time was known as Dashapura. It's of important one marker ke liye, Dashapura at that time, Mansur, Madhya Pradesh, Dashapura. But why, interesting, the one interesting thing is this, why they suddenly took this migration, why they came to Dashapura, because they heard about the greatness of the local king in Dashapura. Dashapura mein jo local king tha, uska jo greatness sunke, ye log us raja ke kingdom mein rehne ke liye, raja ke kingdom mein rehne ke liye ye log nikal pade. So that is jati ke bare mein, theek hai. So two points for jati. This source is not that important. And what is this? The case of the merchant. Sanskrit text inscriptions use the term, yes, वनीक टू डेसिग्नेट मर्चेंट. मर्चेंट्स के नाम है संस्कृत टेक्स्ट में, वनीक मीनिंग मर्चेंट्स. वाइल ट्रेड वॉज डिफाइंड एज एन ऑक्यूपेशन फॉर वैश्यास इन द शास्त्रास, धर्मशास्त्रास, अ मोर कॉम्प्लेक्स सिचुएशन इज एविडेंट प्लेस सच एज मिर्च कटिका. मिर्च कटिका इज रिटन बाई शूद्रकाय. क्वेश्चन सब बहुत सारे एग्जाम्स में आए हैं और इवन आवर बोर्ड एग्जाम्स ऑल्सो दे आस्क दिस. Mrichikatika is a book written by Shudraka. And here in this Mrichikatika, the hero is Charudatta, was described as both Brahmana as well as Sartavaha, that is a merchant. So merchant supposed to be a Vaishya, but यहाँ पे हमारे ये मृच्छकटिका का जो हीरो है, ये जो एपिक प्ले है, प्ले में जो हीरो चारुदत्ता इज बोथ ब्राह्मणा एज वेल एज वैश्य, बिकॉज वैश्य ओनली कैन डू मर्चेंट ट्रेड, वही कर सकते. सो ही कॉल्ड देम हिमसेल्फ एज दिस. एज द 5th सेंचुरी इंस्क्रिप्शन डिस्क्राइब्स टू ब्रदर्स हु मेड अ डोनेशन फॉर द कंस्ट्रक्शन ऑफ द टेम्पल ऑफ क्षत्रिय वणिक. जो ये सब हिस्ट्री में बताया कि वो क्षत्रिय भी है और वणिक भी है. So such things also can happen. The case of the merchants, just merchants के merchants के बारे में अगर कोई short history बताएं तो ये history है, ठीक है. इसको आपको एक answer के रूप में नहीं याद करना है. What you need to learn is vanik meaning merchants, and यहाँ पे हमारे पास दो ऐसा situations है जहाँ पे वो ब्राह्मणा भी है और वनिक भी है, क्षत्रिय भी है और वनिक भी है. मृच्छकटिका written by Shudraka, that you need to know. Fine. Now beyond this four varnas, that is integration, we have so many people. People are not within this four varnas and they are considered to be described as very very old people, and they are uncivilized people, even animal like people. ये सब ये ब्राह्मणिकल थियरी कहता है. मैं नहीं कह रहा हूँ, दिस ऑल रिटन इन द बुक. सो इफ दे डोंट कम अंडर दिस फोर एंड दे आर No, comes considered to be uncivilized, even animal-like people. In some instances, they included forest dwellers for whom hunting and gathering remained an important means of subsistence. These people are called uncivilized people. Okay, categories such as Nishada, the Eklavya belongs to this community. Okay, very important. A question asked sakta hai. Nishada community, Eklavya belongs to this. So others were viewed with suspicion. Even kuch log hai, unko kisme rakhe four varnas mein ya निषादा कम्युनिटी में कहा रखे, उसको सस्पिशन के रूप में अगर देखते हैं तो दे आर कॉल्ड नोमैडिक पास्टरलिस्ट, बिकॉज वो एक जगह पे नहीं रहते हैं, घूमते फिरते हैं, क्या कभी कुछ अटैक करेंगे, चोरी करेंगे. सो वुड नॉट बी इजिली अकोमोडेटेड विद इन द फ्रेमवर्क ऑफ सेटल्ड एग्रीकल्चर. सो दिस पीपल समटाइम्स स्पोक अदर लैंग्वेजेस, नॉट संस्कृत एंड अदर लैंग्वेजेस, एंड दे आर कॉल्ड मेलिचास एंड लुक डाउन. दे आर ऑलवेज लुक डाउन अपॉन, दे आर नॉट रेस्पेक्टेड बाई द पीपल. सो दिस इज beyond four varnas. Tiger husband, please go through a story here, both not so important, please go through. Now beyond this four varnas, subordination and conflict, ye pehle jo humne abhi dekha tha isme koi zyada important point nahi hai, lekin you should know this this Eklavya belongs to Nishada community, theek hai. Ye jo integration hai na, beyond four varnas and integration, bas iska jo main मतलब पॉइंट लिखने का जो पॉइंट है हमें इधर मिलेगा, ठीक है, इसमें से. नाउ ब्राह्मणास कंसीडर्ड सम पीपल एज बीइंग आउटसाइड द सिस्टम, सो दे आल्सो डेवलप्ड अ शार्पर सोशल डिवाइड बाय क्लासिफाइंग सर्टेन सोशल कैटेगरीज एज अनटचेबल. तो ये फोर है जो मेन है, इनको वो लोग एक्सेप्ट करते हैं, लेकिन कुछ लोग हैं जो उनको उसे क्लास अनटचेबल्स के रूप में. The this rested on a notion that certain activities, especially those connected with the performance of rituals, were very sacred and by expansion of pure. So people who are within this four and they are considered to be considered by them, and those who are not, they are not considered and they are called untouchable. Those who consider themselves pure avoided taking food from these people who are untouchables. Okay, to apne aap ko jo pure mante hain wo ye untouchables hai, they avoid taking food from them, even water from them. In sharp contrast to the purity of aspect, some activities were regarded as very very polluting. This included handling of corpses, corpses mean dead bodies and dead animals. So ye sab kaam jo karne wale hain wo sab polluted log hain. Those who performed such tasks like these people are called as chandalas. Yese se kaam karne walon ko ye bahut important hai, chandalas. They were placed at the very bottom of the hierarchy. Ye shudras ke aur niche hain. Their touch, even seeing them, was regarded as polluting by those who claimed to be at the top of the social order. Mainly by Brahmanas and Kshatriyas and Vaishyas, ये जो चंडालास को देखना ही ये लोग pollution मानते हैं. Now Manusmriti, one of the Dharma Sutras and Shastras में book है, it laid some duties for the Chandalas. एक question अलग से आ सकता है आपके लिए, what are the duties laid down by Manusmriti for the Chandalas? What are the first? They had to live outside the village. Okay, first duty is वो लोग village से बाहर ही रह सकते हैं. Okay, then and use discarded utensils. Utensils means vessels. They have to the vessels which are discarded. Not they need. They cannot go and buy new one. जो use करके हम फेंक देते हैं उसको. And they have to wear clothes of the dead and ornaments of iron. Clothes of the dead people and ornaments of the iron. They cannot wear the ornaments of silver or gold or bronze. They could not walk about in the villages and cities at night. They had to dispose of the bodies of those who had no relatives and serve there as executioners. Okay, so these are some of the duties. यहाँ तक execution तक आपको points में तीन चार point में लिख सकते हैं, ये short answer में आ सकता है. Duties laid down by the Maharashtrapati for the Chandalas. Now we have two Chinese travelers. We have studied about them so many times. The first one is Fagian, who came in 5th century CE. He wrote about this. About these people, untouchables. Untouchables had to sound a clapper in the street so that people could avoid seeing them. उन्होंने ये ऑब्जर्व किया कि देखा इंडिया में, तो इन्होंने अपने बुक में लिखा है कि अनटचेबल जब भी आते हैं तो दे हैव टू मेक अ नो क्लैपर, दे हैव टू मेक अ साउंड सो दैट पीपल कैन गेट इन साइड देयर हाउस सो दैट दे कैन अवॉइड दम. ओके, नॉट नॉट सीइंग दम. अनदर चाइनीज पिलग्रिम Wan Swang, who came in 7th century, he also observed that the executioners and scavengers are forced to live outside. वो जाके बाहर अपने मन से नहीं रहना चाहते. They are forced to live outside the city. These untouchables. So these are Chandalas के बारे में कुछ भी क्वेश्चन शॉर्ट आंसर में आए तो आपको ये पैराग्राफ पूरा अच्छे से पॉइंट्स में लिखना पड़ेगा, एंड इंक्लूडिंग द ऑब्जर्वेशंस बाय फागियान एंड वान स्वांग. दैट ऑल्सो यू नीड टू समराइज. द लास्ट पैराग्राफ नॉट सो इम्पॉर्टेंट. So Bodhisatta Chandala, okay, we have a Chandala in the form of Bodhisatta. We'll study about who is this Bodhisatta and all that in the next chapter, Buddhism, Jainism. Next chapter हम पढ़ेंगे, बहुत important interesting chapter है. And in this, did Chandalas resist the attempts to push them to the bottom of social order? Read this story, and we have a part of Mattanga Jataka. It's a Pali text, Buddhist text. One of the Bodhisatta was born outside the city. Banaras Chandala's son named Mattanga. So Mattanga is a person very important, Bodhisatta, one of the gods, the disciples of chosen ones, not disciples, chosen ones of Buddha. Mattanga, he was son of Chandala. He had gone to the city some work. He encountered Thitta Mangalika, the daughter of the merchant. When he saw him, she exclaimed that I have seen something inauspicious and all that. Washed her eyes. Something inauspicious, and so how he witnessed social discrimination, Mattanga, that is being explained here in this source. Sources and all, please go read. You read, and if any doubt, we'll clarify it. But otherwise, it's all sources, all story. If it is something that has to be explained, then I will explain. Otherwise, if it is a story, then just go through them. Okay. So with that, we have completed another important topic in this lesson, that is caste, about caste system. Anything related to caste system we have covered. So you have to start with explaining the four varnas and all that. Okay, fine. When we start the next session, I'll quickly summarize this. Okay. Otherwise, I think I have explained enough for you for this answer. Any short answers, दो इसमें से आ सकते हैं. एक non क्षत्रिय kings के बारे में आ सकते हैं, दूसरा Chandalas के बारे में आ सकते हैं. दोनों थोड़ा important है. बाकी four वर्णास के बारे में आ सकते हैं. आ गया तो इतना easy question, इससे easy question कुछ हो ही नहीं सकता. Otherwise, we have done two, three sources which are very important, like proper social roles वो वाला, और ये डिवाइन ऑर्डर वाला. ये दोनों थोड़ा इम्पोर्टेंट है. ओके, प्लीज स्टडी, डोंट वेस्ट योर टाइम. वी डोंट हैव मच टाइम, वी आर इन क्लास 12. वी डोंट हैव मच टाइम. प्लीज डोंट थिंक दैट वी डोंट हैव, वी आर नॉट हैविंग नॉर्मल क्लासेस, सो वी नीड नॉट स्टडी. जब नॉर्मल क्लास स्टार्ट होंगे तो हम पढ़ लेंगे, ऐसा आप मत सोचना. वी आर नॉट वेरी श्योर कि वेन वी आर गोइंग टू स्टार्ट अवर नॉर्मल क्लासेस. दिस इज द नॉर्मल क्लास फॉर यू. You are a special people, and this is the normal class, and this is how you have to study for your 12th board exam. There is nothing, there is no shortcut. You don't wait for normal classes to begin. It may happen too late, and that won't be sufficient for you. That time won't be sufficient for you to prepare for your board exams. So I request you all to study, make short notes, and write in a copy or make short notes of your own and study. Don't waste your time. Any doubt, we have the live stream on 22nd July. That day, you can ask me the doubts. Till then, all of you, take care. Bye-bye.